Hello, this is Toby, and I'm installing this ductless air 24,000 BTU unit today. I'm going to do a quick video on it and just show you the key points of putting one in. Had a lot of requests for the 24,000, so I'm going to do this quick key video. And here's the air handler, and as you can see, basically this is going in a garage area. It's about 500 square feet, low insulation. And we've got 100 degree days, so it should do a real good job. One of the key things I want to point out is on the wiring. That's where common mistakes are made, and it's number one. So this right here is actually my note where I made the wiring outside and I wrote it down. And the key points are, you just want to make sure inside is exactly as outside. Starting up here on the left, it's terminal. You can't see the terminals because the wires are covering it up, but it's 1, 2, and 3 from left to right. 1, 2, and 3, and then here we have our high voltage, which is coming from outside, L3, L4, and ground. So you can see where I made my note here, from outside terminals. Basically, 1 is black, labeled as 1, 2 is red, labeled as 2, 3 is yellow, labeled as 3, and then on my L3, L4, and ground, there is no labels. Basically, they're just stripped back terminals. So L3 is black, no label. L4 is red, no label. And green is yellow, no label. So everything is just like that on the back. Then we have our sensor wire, which basically is connected right back there. You can't see it because it's already covered up, but we'll go outside and I will show you what it looks like out here. And basically I'm going through the wall with it, turned down. I'm gonna have my drain line straight down, wires coming over here, condensers sitting right in front, and you can see how bright the sun is today. It's hot. That's why I'm not making a long video. But basically what we're doing is, it came with a 25-foot line set. I cut it down. Minimum line set's 10 foot, so I cut it down to 10 foot. I made my new flares, and basically here is our same connections. If you can see that, see if we can get you a good view here. So from left to right is the same as inside. 1, 2, and 3. Black labeled as 1, red labeled as 2, yellow labeled as 3. Then we got L3, L4, and ground, which is black no label, red no label, and then yellow is ground. Then here on our far side, these are our high voltage coming in from our disconnect. So it's L1, L2, and then ground's over here. And that comes from to our conduit, and basically that goes to our disconnect on the wall. So that's how far we've gotten. We've got these already secured. I like to take it outside the wall and make my connections straight out the back. It makes life so much easier and easier to check later. Go straight out the back. We got our CPS torque wrench. We torque all of them down. Basically, you just put it on here, set your torque specifications to where you want it. And I think this one calls for 65, and the 3/8 line calls for 42. But double check on the installation instructions and make sure. So I got these torqued down, got my gauges hooked to it, and I have my nitrogen tank hooked to that. Basically, we're sitting at 150, and with these digital ones, I mean, they're about as accurate as something can get. Sitting on 150, it's been there for about 5 minutes. I'm going to keep it there for about another 5 minutes to make sure nothing moves. And then, of course, I use Big Blue soap bubbles, and I just double check and recheck everything. And I'll soap bubble this joint up here before I go and wrap all my lines up and make everything neat. Once I'm 100% certain we don't have any leaks, then I will go ahead and dump the gas. So now's a good time. I'm gonna finish doing my leak test, put it up under a vacuum. While it's vacuuming out, I'm gonna finish my wire in here, and then we'll start it up. Okay, we got it all started up here. Basically what we did was, after it held our pressure, we vacuumed it down, And we got the two caps here. You unscrew those with a metric Allen wrench. I think it was a 5. And now we're going to just clean up everything. We have our line set coming out. And I did it on purpose and didn't put the line set cover over it, just to show how easy it'll be done after the fact. So when you do your services on these machines, you can come back later if you see where somebody didn't put a cover on it and add a little kit real easily. So we'll be covering that right now. One thing I do want to touch on is I did cut the line set down. It comes 25 feet. I cut it down to 10 feet. It's a minimum of 10 feet. So that's why, let's move this out of the way. That's why you see I curved it around the back and then in the side here, and it comes out the side of the machine. That's why I did that, so I can get 10 feet out of it. You need to have a minimum of 10 feet line set. And of course, I just cut the flares off and reflared it, and you can see right here is one of the flares we cut off. So that's basically it. Just on startup, check your voltage here. Make sure you have 240 volt on a 18 and 24. If you got a 9 and 12, then it's 110, of course. And start it up and just cut it on and start it up, and you should be good. Pull your vacuum, dump your charge, and start it up. So it's just that easy. And next segment you'll see is I'll just do a quick one on this line set cover here and show y'all how to install it. It's real quick. It'll probably take me all of 10 minutes to have it done, and he can paint it the same color as this building. Okay.